इट इज काउंसलिंग एंड एडमिशन टाइम. आफ्टर क्लियरिंग योर पीजी एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन रिजल्ट्स आर आउट एंड एवरी स्टूडेंट इज बिजी इन इंक्वायरिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट ब्रांचेस एंड इंस्टीट्यूट्स. दिस इज द टाइम वेर स्टूडेंट्स आर कन्फ्यूज अबाउट सो मेनी थिंग्स एंड वन ऑफ देम इज अबाउट BNB. देर आर सो मेनी मिसकनसेप्शन एंड मिस अबाउट दिस कोर्स. स्टूडेंट्स हैव सो मेनी क्वेश्चन अबाउट MBE, इक्विवेलेंस ऑफ BNB टू MD और MS, मेडिकल एंड सर्जिकल ब्रांचेस इन BNB, ट्रेनिंग इन BNB, एग्जिट एग्जाम एंड फ्यूचर आफ्टर पासिंग BNB एग्जामिनेशन. सो इन दिस वीडियो आई विल ट्राई टू एड्रेस ऑल योर क्वेरीज. आई होप बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो यू विल हैव ए क्लियर विजन अबाउट BNB. Those who don't know me, my name is Dr. Khazi Arifuddin and I am a general surgeon. So without wasting any time, let's get started. In India, basically, medical postgraduate degree is allotted by two authorities. One degree is MD or MS, which is allotted by local universities, state university, deemed university, and some of the central universities. Whereas another degree is BNB, which is allotted by National Board of Examination. After passing MBBS, you have to take a formal training of 3 years to get either MD-MS or BNB as a postgraduate degree. MD-MS courses are run in medical colleges where there is a specified department and trained professors and associates which are dedicated for the training of those students. BNB is mainly run in the private hospitals, and now some of the central government institutes and government hospitals are also providing BNB training. So the basic difference is that here students are trained under some senior consultants which are not teachers, but they are experienced enough to teach the students. One of the biggest myths about BNB course is that it is a diploma. BNB means Diplomat of National Board, but there is a difference between diploma and diplomat. So our perception about BNB as diploma is completely wrong. BNB is a well-recognized national and international degree. So many students talk about pros and cons of BNB. There are so many positive things and negative things about BNB too. Now first, talk about the positive things. During the counseling, BNB is less preferred as compared to the MD and MS. So entry into the BNB is relatively easy. So it is a good thing about those students who are passionate about the branch. So those students who do not get their dream branch in MD or MS, they can opt in BNB. So basically, BNB gives you an opportunity to live your dream, and with a postgraduate degree in your favorite subject, you can live your life happily. Another positive thing is that BNB course is run in big hospitals. So these big institutes are usually equipped with latest instruments and they provide higher tertiary care. So you get exposed to the very high quality treatment, and you are also exposed to the private practice where you can learn from your consultant that how to deal with the private patients, how to bargain, how to talk about the treatment cost and everything. These are the things which are lacking in MD or MS courses, because these MD and MS courses are run in medical colleges where the cost of treatment is very low, and at many times you need not to discuss about the cost of the treatment and to convince the patient about the money expenditure. Also, in the big hospitals, you are exposed to so many latest advancements like laser surgeries, robotic surgeries, and other recent technologies. So this is also a plus point of doing BNB. If you talk about the exit exam, the exam is held at the central level where you are sent to the different states, and the exam is OSCE based. So after passing the examination, your confidence is high because you have passed a central examination. Also, OSCE is a method of examination at international level. It is said that BNB students are academically better as they are already exposed to OSCE system, so they perform better in MRCS and FRCS and other international examinations. Another very good thing about DNB course is that there is no bond. Once you have passed your examination, you are free to practice everywhere. You can go abroad and there is no restriction from the board. So these are the major positive things about DNB course. Of course, there are some cons too. DNB is wrongly considered inferior to MD or MS, as DNB occurs in big hospitals. So consultants over there are patient oriented and they are less bothered about academics. So for them, giving patient care is their first priority and teaching to their students comes later. Though there are some DNB institutes which provide excellent academics. Another big problem is that in private hospitals, most of the patients, they come by the name of the consultant. So mostly consultant gives the treatment by himself. So these postgraduate students are mostly used as an assistant. In surgical branches, these consultants are hesitant to give cutting or hands-on to the students because they don't want to compromise their care. So at the end of the training, some of the DNB students are not competent to perform independent procedures. If you are doing DNB course in any government hospital or at the hospitals which are run by central government, you get plenty of hands-on and you are equally competent to your MD-MS friends. The biggest problem of DNB course is the low passing rate. Exit exam of DNB is very tough. Practical examination in DNB is not held at your own institute. As compared to the MD or MS, your practical examination is held at your own institute where you give exam in your familiar environment where two of your examiners are your own teachers. So basically it is a very comfortable position for any student to give examination. Whereas for DNB, practical examination is held at different states where you have to give examination in totally different atmosphere where all four examiners are not your teacher. You see them for the first time. Sometimes you get your practical center at a center where you don't know the local language. So in the new hospital, new ward where you don't know anybody, all the four examiners, you don't know about them. And sometimes it is difficult to communicate because of different language. So altogether, it is a very difficult situation for any student. Also, the pattern of the examination is OSCE, so there is very less margin of error. So everything makes very difficult for the student to pass in the examination. Considering all these factors, the passing rate of DNB is very low, but nowadays it is improving. The biggest reason for this is the centralized counseling. A decade before, DNB admission was through a personal interview-based counseling. But now, after the introduction of a centralized admission process, now the good students are coming into this degree. Also, over the period of time, students are knowing more and more about the exam pattern. Of course, the passing rate in DNB has improved. And you can see so many students who have passed their DNB in the first attempt. Once you have passed DNB, you have a lot of opportunity. But when it comes to teaching posts, MD-MS are preferred over DNB because MD-MS is done through a teaching institute or from any medical college, so that training is considered as experience. So as far as teaching post is considered, DNB requires extra year of experience as compared to their MD-MS friends. To solve this problem, some amendments are made. Now, if any student who does DNB from a teaching institute or any institute which is having 500 or more than 500 beds are considered equally experienced. So if you have passed your DNB from any teaching institute or any hospital which has more than 500 beds, you are equal in terms of your teaching post and the job opportunity for them is equal to MD and MS. This is probably the biggest misconception about DNB. Let me clear one thing. DND is equivalent to MD or MS beyond any doubt. When it comes to eligibility for your super specialty exam like DM or MCH or job opportunity anywhere. But as I mentioned about the teaching post, you have to fulfill the criteria of 500 bed or teaching institute. Though there was discrimination because of the perception, but now it has greatly reduced after the government has officially declared MD equivalent to MD or MS. Many students have doubts regarding different branches in DNB. Some of them say that medicinal branches are good in DNB, whereas surgical branches are not that good. But let me tell you, I know so many people who are DNB, but they are very good when it comes to hands-on or in their practice. So even if you choose surgical branches in DNB, if you are passionate about your field, you can develop very good skills and you will be equally competent. Training of DNB is same as that of MD or MS. As I told, it is slightly more than 3 years. In other words, you can say 3.5 years. During that period, you have to work in the institute under the supervision of your mentor or guide. During that period, you have to do thesis also. That thesis is submitted to the National Board of Examination. During your training, you are entitled to work in OPDs, wards. If you are choosing any surgical branch, then you have to work in OT also. At many institutes, you are allowed to handle patients independently. As I said, the consultants are not that much academically oriented, but some of the institutes, they are providing excellent academics. And if you are lucky that your consultant is interested in academics, then it will be very wonderful for you, because there will be a schedule for your academics, seminars, case presentation, journal club, everything will be covered. During the training, you can attend different conferences, you can participate in that, you can present your cases over there, you can do poster presentations. So in short, you have ample of opportunity to groom yourself and develop your skills. Another concern is about stipend. By and large, stipend of any DNB course is equivalent to the stipend of MD-MS student of that particular state. Social media is full of such questions. In so many Facebook and WhatsApp groups, students ask about which DNB institute is to be preferred. So I'll give my personal opinion based on my general experience about different institutes. First preference should be given to the central institutes. Railway institutes, ESI, and institutes which are run by central government, they provide excellent exposure of the patient and also stipend is higher. So for me, that will be my first preference. After that comes government institutes, some of the medical colleges and also some district and civil hospitals, they provide DNB degree. These institutes have a high volume of patients where you are allowed to do independent procedures and you get very good exposure. So obviously that will be my second choice. After that comes the big hospitals of metro cities, because these hospitals, they provide very good care and also it is equipped with latest instruments. So you get to see highest level of care under the guidance of experienced and knowledgeable consultants. You may not get very good hands-on, but that will definitely give you a very good exposure of that field. And my last preference will be the periphery centers where you don't get much experience and faculties over there may not be that good. But if you are determined and you are very passionate about that field, then you can learn anywhere. And as far as academic is concerned, in the post-graduation, there is no spoon-feeding. So everything you have to learn by yourself. In this era of internet, you get so many online lectures and also you can see so many procedures on YouTube and other platforms. So if at your institute you don't get good academics, you can use all these platforms and you can develop all these skills. You can consider subscribing to my channel, because on my channel I give you so many tricks and I suggest you so many things which can help you to do your post graduation so that you can extract maximum from your postgraduate training. No doubt, DNB exit exam is very tough. At the end of 3 years, you have to give a theory examination. If you pass in that theory examination, then you have 3 chances to pass your practical examination. For practical examination, DNB has divided India into different regions, such as East region, North region, South, West, like that. So if you are doing your postgraduate training in one particular state, mostly you don't get practical center in your own region. If you are doing post-graduation from West Bengal, then you may get center in North region or in the West. As I told, these examinations are OSCE based and you have to perform in unfamiliar conditions in front of all 4 unfamiliar examiners. So basically they judge only your knowledge, whereas in MD and MS, 2 of the examiners are from the same institute who have seen you over the period of 3 years. So while evaluating, they also consider your 3 years of work. So on the day of examination, unfortunately, you don't perform well. At that time, these 2 internals, they may consider your 3 years of work and you definitely have soft corner. That is the reason the passing rate in MD-MS is almost 100%, whereas in DNB, your work is not considered. And if you perform good on that particular day, then you are passed. Unfortunately, if you don't perform, then obviously you have to again appear for the examination. But let me tell you, because everybody knows before admission that passing DNB is very tough. So they start preparing from the day one. And DNB students are constantly under pressure that they have to give very tough exit exam. So obviously they are very oriented from the beginning. So I would recommend, if you are ready to take that challenge, you can take DNB without any hesitation. It is a very tough question. Let me tell you one thing. Good doctor or bad doctor, all these things come from developing your own skill, irrespective of your degree. Whether it is MD-MS or DNB, if the student is very hardworking, then he can excel. I know many people from both DNB and MD-MS who are very good, both academically and practically. In my opinion, if you work on your skills, then you can shine with any degree, let it be DNB or MD-MS. Some of the students are in a very tricky situation. At their rank, they can get both DNB or diplomas, and they are very confused whether to take diploma or DNB. Let me tell you one thing. After doing diplomas, there are less opportunities as compared to the DNB. DNB is a degree which should always be preferred over diplomas. Of course, after passing diploma, you can spend 2 more years and you can also get DNB degree. But if you ask me my preference between diploma and DNB, then definitely I would advise for DNB. But suppose you are getting diploma in your favorite branch, at that time you can opt for diploma. But I would recommend, after completing your diploma, go for secondary DNB. In terms of job opportunities in private sector, both MD-MS or DNBs, these are considered equal. Now coming to the government jobs. As I told, in teaching courses, MD-MS are preferred over DNB. But now this gap is reducing, and if you are DNB, then you have to work 1 year extra in any teaching institute. After that, you are equal. I know some of the DNB doctors who are associate professors, professors, or even HOD. Now with the new rule, DNB and MD-MS are equal. If the candidate has done DNB from any teaching institute or any institute which has more than 500 beds. Now coming to the job opportunities in abroad. It is said that in abroad, DNB is preferred over MD or MS because DNB degree is allotted by national board. Internationally, board degrees are preferred over university degrees. It doesn't mean that MD or MS students don't get opportunities in abroad, but as I said, DNB is preferred. But one good news for MD and MS students, after completing their degree, they can just give one theory and practical examination. After that, they can get DNB degree also. To summarize, DNB is equivalent to MD and MS, while there is equal training, good opportunities in the future, but only disadvantage in the teaching courses. If you get your dream branch in DNB, then I would recommend to go for that. With this, I sign off. If you have enjoyed this video, do press the like button, share it with your friends, and subscribe to my channel. All the very best, and thanks for watching this video.